He got a plan. He got a plan. And whatever Devin should do next, I'm going to support him and rock with him. But I know one thing. I mean, I know your next question is, you know, can he be this one? Can he be that one? I'm going to tell you like this straight up. Devin could go hand for hand, chest for chest with any fighter in the game right now. And most of these guys right now that we see, we know, we watch, Devin knows how to set traps. And trust me, he's hitting harder than a lot of guys think. Trust me.
You saw him do mitts with Floyd. What went through your mind? I mean, he was soaking it in. Devin was doing mitts with Floyd.
Yeah, that was great. I mean, anytime a young fighter can get a chance to work with a fighter from the past, somebody else that went through the game and was great at what it was great at what they did and to pass that knowledge along and to get it, man, suck it up. Any opportunity any fighter get like that, I tell them, take it and learn all you can learn. You know what I'm saying? Floyd Mayweather is, just keep it real, he's a master. He's a master in the ring. He's a master at what he did. He's a master at what he do. You know what I'm saying? And for him to pass knowledge on to Devin, I hope Devin is, and I know he is, Devin is listening and learning 100%. You know, that's one of Devin's number one fighter that he likes. And, you know what I'm saying? He watches him and, you know, he takes the good that he takes from him and he creates his own self. It's Devin Haney. Nobody gonna mess with him. Watch what I tell you. There's a lot of great young guys out here, but when the smoke clear, young Haney gonna be standing right there. Watch that. Trust me.
No, he's special. He's been special since he was a little kid.
Yeah.
And in boxing, one thing I realized that it doesn't matter what you do, you're gonna get criticized. If you knock out someone early, he was a bum.
Yeah.
If you go the distance, why didn't you get him out early?
Yeah.
You can't make people happy.
You can't make them happy. You can't. Not in this game. I mean, we know that. We watch this game so many times. I mean, you know what I mean? So, hey, what can I say?
Teofimo Lopez Lomachenko. Who do you like?
Teofimo Lopez. I like Teofimo in that fight.
Why?
I ain't gonna lie. I like the way he comes off. I like the way he comes off in that fight, you know what I'm saying? Teofimo is he reminds me a lot of myself when I was coming up. He got a lot of heart. He coming forward. He don't care about nobody. He ain't scared to get hit. You know, he gonna come in there and fight. You know what I'm saying? And that's the way, I like Teofimo. I'm going with Teofimo on that one.
Now, Zap, I know you've been good friends with everybody in boxing. What is your craziest Mike Tyson story? Because everyone has one.
Oh man. I don't know, Mike is my brother, man. Like for real. Like, you know what I mean? We shared and through the times of our life so many different encounters and experiences and ups and downs and all the stories are great, man. It's just great. I mean, you gotta love Mike Tyson for the person that he is, man. You know what I'm saying? No matter what nobody say about him, you know, we can say good, bad, nobody, but you're gonna say Mike is Mike. Nobody else came close to doing it.
Did you ever spar him?
Huh?
Did you ever spar him?
No.
Hey,
I mean, we got a ring and played like around, but no way, like spar him. I'm 30 seconds. I wouldn't even be 30 seconds. I mean, I'm afraid Mike was. I used to be in the gym and watch him drop. Motherfucker 260 pounds with headgear, and he wore 20-ounce gloves. He was folding these guys. I was like, I'm not getting in there. You crazy? Never in a million years.
He's looking great these days. He's working on a comeback. What do you want to see him do? Do you want to see him fight Andy Ruiz? Do you want to see him fight Evander? Do you want to see him fight, you know, maybe someone from the UFC like Cain Velasquez?
Listen, man, bro know what he's doing. You know, he know who he can go in there with, and he know how he could do it, and, you know what I'm saying, I hope that he just go in there and, you know, be safe, no matter what, you know what I'm saying, father time play games with nobody ducks him, he's undefeated, you know what I'm saying, when he chooses to kick in, he kick in, you know what I'm saying, I mean, like I said, he could do whatever he want to do, he's Mike, he getting in great shape, you know what I'm saying? Feel good. He could possibly put it off. You know what I'm saying? Just don't get hurt. Like,
no, that's true. But I'm gonna say, people always say bad things about people. Like, they talk about Mike, they talk about you, they say, they talk about Floyd. And look, Floyd paid for George Floyd's funeral. And it wasn't a little sum, it was $88,000. It didn't surprise me. Did it surprise you?
No, 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 no. I mean, he got money out the ass. Money's that.
But usually, Zab, the richest people I know are the cheapest. They're the ones that always say, Ellie, you got 20 bucks? I don't have money for parking.
Yeah.
Not him. I'm saying you the know rich what? People.
You know what? You know what? You know what? When you have a certain upbringing, been through a certain things in life, and be around a certain group of people in a certain environment of people, your heart tend to go out faster than somebody that's in the penthouse, don't see nobody, go from the penthouse straight to the car, underground, come outside, you in the back of the car, docked out, tinted out, straight to the venue, the back door. You don't see nobody. You don't know people. When you on the front line and you out there, you in the hood, you on the front line, you sitting on the park benches, you hearing the homie story, you look different. You looking like, when you got all that, like you got, you like, you sitting around, you hear somebody, what? Nah, I'm going to take care of that. Because money's not an object. You know what I'm saying? When it becomes not an object, like how he's put himself in, he put himself in a good situation. Money's not an object right now. So when you got like that and somebody tell you, yo, $80,000, you almost got $1 billion. $80,000 is less like a fucking giving somebody 5 cents. Like, that ain't shit. You know what I mean? So, you do it.
But it was nice of him to do. And it's nice that he got the credit, because most of the time when you guys do stuff like this, even you, Zab, you don't tell nobody. You just do it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because you don't do that. You know, I don't do it for that. I don't do it for attention or fame or exposure, because he take care of me. That's who take care of me. So, God bless, you know what I'm saying? When he give me a lot, you know what I'm saying? My job is to spread the love, brother. You don't eat all that fucking meal by yourself. You spread the love. You know what I'm saying? That's how, and that's what I've always learned. And I got brothers and a big family that'll tell you that's what I do. I spread the love. I ain't got no problem with that. That's all I know is, like, I can't go take all this shit and go in the corner. It's all mine. I don't know how to do that. I grew up in a house with all boys. Like, you couldn't do that shit anyway. You better know how to fight. You know what I mean?
Okay. It's Mike different. Tyson loves to play dice. Did you ever play with him?
Yeah, me and Mike play a lot of times. I mean, you know what I'm saying? Big Bang take all the bank. That's what Mike was. You know what I'm saying? You couldn't break it. See what it was? When you got money like that and you playing games, I might take 10,000 from Mike on the thing, but then Mike gonna come and play 10,000 a hand. He gonna get me on one of them hands and he gonna take all my bread. You know what I'm saying? Now that's Big Bang take little bank. You know what I'm saying? He got the ability. If I take 10,000, he gonna say, all right, run it all back. Your 10 versus my 10, drop it. And he hit it and bang. Now I'm back to square one again. You know what I'm saying? So in those situations, you gotta be smart. When you hit gold, he come with that. Listen, man, I'm good. My bank is $50 again. You know what I'm saying? You gotta go BK. Like, yo, my bank is 50 again. Fuck all that. Fuck all that. I ain't shooting no 10,000 in the hand, my ass.
Were you there when Tupac walked him in?
No.
But did you ever meet Tupac?
Yeah.
Tell me about that. What was that like?
We met at a house. We was kicking it. We was chilling. It wasn't my meeting with him. It was someone else meeting, and I just happened to be there. And it was like, listen, he's like, oh shit, I know, yeah, and we kicked it. You know what I'm saying? It was dope. It's the big homie.
Who's the, in your opinion, the greatest rapper ever? Because you met a lot of them. You were in the music and business industry too.
My opinion is my opinion. I like Jay. I mean, that's my, everybody know me. Know I like Jay-Z. You know?
Did you happen to hear Adrian Broner's new music? It's pretty good.
Nah. You know what? We got a surprise for y'all, you know. I spoke with AB today. Me and AB's in, you know. That's something for y'all.
A lot of people are criticizing, saying, why is he demanding $10 million? And I said, listen, you got to start negotiating somewhere. You put a price, and then you can move up, you can move down. But if you don't put a price, they don't know where to start.
Well, in life, the thing people, a lot of people don't do is say what you want and mean, say what you want and mean what you say. That's it. Stay behind. You know, a lot of times, a lot of fights I got and I got paid the way I got paid was because I asked people, they said what you want. This is what I want. I said, okay, cool, let's go. I said, all right, cool. You know what I'm saying? But a lot of times, if you sit back and do the, oh, well, maybe I think that I'm, then you're not going to get it. You got to be firm. Yo, listen, I want this. He going to get 10 man. Don't worry about it. He going to get 10 man. That's not going to be hard for him to get. He going to get it.
He's very talented, four-division champion, and he's a big personality. He crossed over very, not only the boxing. Like, people know him everywhere.
And he's young. He's talented. He got, you know what I'm saying, character. You know what I'm saying? He's marketable. You know what I'm saying? I mean, what can you say? The kid is, he did good for himself.
By the way, today is Roberto Duran's birthday.
Oh, word. Happy birthday.
Is he the greatest 135 ever?
I don't know, because Pernell Whitaker was 135 too. So I can't.
It's hard to answer.
Yeah.
What about Pacquiao? Pacquiao's
he great though. Shout out to that's my big homie, Roberto Duran. He a legend. In his time, yes, he was the best at what he did. You know what I'm saying? Of all time, all around great. You know, you can't say that. I have people ask me, what would have happened if you would have fought Sugar Ray Leonard? I'm like, first of all, I wouldn't even comment on that because to me, that's disrespect. You know, he's a legend. He paved the way for myself to come along and do what I came to do. You know what I'm saying? Without him coming before and doing what he did, his little one, who I don't know if I would have been able to come through and speak and talk like how I did. All of the legends for that to be, you know what I'm saying, exact.
It's like when they asked Mike Tyson, you in your prime, Ali in his prime, and he said, oh, he always says Ali would win because he says he respects him so much.
Of course. I would never try to even align myself with any legends that came before me. You know what I'm saying? Because I take it as disrespect for one of these, a young kid to be like, oh, if that dude was, I would have watched, like.
Zap, of all your opponents, and you fought everyone, who had the fastest hands?
Maybe Corey Spinks. No, Corey Spinks.
Corey Spinks. Who was the dirtiest? Who, like, knew every trick in the book? Like, when the ref looks to hit you with the knee, to hit you on the Charlie horse?
Man.
Headbutt?
Cotto? Cotto was good.
He knew. Did you get back at him when someone hits you, like, slick?
Man, I tried, man. But remember, it was in the garden. It was a Puerto Rican Day Parade. He had everything on his side, bro. He had the Puerto Rican Day Parade, the garden, the arena, the judges. Everybody was against me, bro. But I stood strong, man. 10 toes down. I grabbed my nuts and went toe to toe, kid. You know that. You know what I'm saying? Even me and Lotte said he hit his tough. That was a tough fight, Zab. Tough. You know, it was a classic. But you know me, I ain't gonna bow down, lay down, or duck or act small. I ain't gonna do it. I'm too tall to act small. You know that.
Of course, Zab, in your career, you won 5 championships, right?
6.
6 championships, sorry. Which fight did you think before would be very hard, but it turned out to be very easy?
None of them was easy. I wouldn't say easy. Because preparation for the fight is what makes the fight hard. You know what I'm saying? Like, the way I train hard for the fight. So, win, lose, or draw, like, the way I trained, I knew similarly what's going to happen in the ring. I already knew. Like I said, man, I train like an animal. This shit ain't going past 4 rounds. Like, I know for a fact, and bang, it was over early. You know what I mean? I knew it. And some fights I knew, Zab, you ain't trained this hard. You ain't do like you posted did. So, all right, this could be a long fight. Or I could catch this motherfucker because I got the dead on. You know what I'm saying? I always had the dead on. Always. If a motherfucker tell you, anybody ever fought me tell you that, can he punch? Hell yeah. That motherfucker catch you and knock the shit out of you. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, if I caught somebody, I knew that I could get rid of him early.
Which one of your opponents hit the hardest that you're like, wow, I can't believe he possesses power like that? Anybody?
Lucas Matiste. That motherfucker, he had different first round. Dean come out, we come out. He threw like a jab and I slipped and it hit me in the shoulder. I said, whoa, what the fuck? I said, wait a minute. I said, so, and, you know, in my mind, I'm not going to show him nothing, but I was like, my mind, what the fuck was that? So I start over again, eat the same thing again. I flip it, bung. I'm like, oh no, fuck that. This motherfucker, what the fuck? He got in his gloves. I'm like, yo, I'm looking at like, yo, this motherfucker got concrete in his gloves or something. And that whole night, I just kept it moving. I was moving and weaving and like boxing. You ain't getting, you're not going to hit me in the face with that. I feel how that, I know how that felt on my shoulder. I'm like, you're not punching me in my face with that. No way. I'm not going for that.
Is that which person that you fought had the fastest hands?
Huh?
Fastest hands.
I just said that, Corey Spinks.
Faster than Amir Khan? Because I just remember you fought Amir too, and Amir has very fast hands.
Corey Spinks.
Who is the most intelligent one?
Floyd Mayweather.
Why? What made him so smart in there?
I don't know what made him so smart. I just know that he was intelligent on the movement. On the psychology of the fighting part, you know what I'm saying? It wasn't the physical part. It was like, because he physically, I was the man. I was strong. I was all that. I was throwing him around all that. But psychology, you know, Floyd's older than me too. You know, psychology. He was smarter than me in there that night. You know what I'm saying? Strategy. He had a good strategy in the plan. He stuck with it and he pulled it through.
Now, Zab, there was a lot of smoke before the fight, which part of it is promotion, but part of it is real. At what point after the fight do you guys become friends again? Because I've seen you at his gym, and you guys are, you know, you're friendly. Does it take a while, or is it right after the fight?
It was different with me and Floyd. Like, me and Floyd was, and you know what? I mean, I'm older now, more mature now. I mean, I probably could say it was me. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? I wasn't satisfied with the turnout of the fighting situation, then the fine and how they took my money, and I was mad. So wherever I seen them at, I was on my bully shit. I was on my Brooklyn bully shit. Like, yo, it was cracking, cuz. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I had got on it like that, and I was just, you know what I mean? I mean, listen, I love him. I mean, nothing maliciously to hurt him or to like take his life or anything like that, you know what I'm saying? Just like, so let's fight again. Let's keep fighting. Let's fight here, outside, inside, wherever. Like, turn up. Like, he knew, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, he knew my body. You know what I'm saying? He knew how he knew how I gave it up. So it was just different.
We have a question here for someone who says, ask Zab about Mayweather up being in a music video, 100 rounds. Raekwon, what's the story behind that?
This is before all that stuff. It was, you know what I'm saying? Me, Flo, this is before. I mean, we didn't get to no heated situation until, like, right before the fight. Maybe, like, two months before the fight is when we got started. When we start like a word, I'm going to see you. I'm going to see you. You know what I mean? Before that, it was love. And then, I mean, to this day right now, you know what I'm saying? Like, he my brother, you know what I mean? I love him. Like, you know what I mean? I would never stand back and see nobody do nothing to him. Or I would never push go on him. Never. I would never. Well, that's my intention. I would never hear go was pushed on him. And I stand back like, all right, I don't know. I ain't gonna do it. Nah, I would not. Everybody know that. Like, I was like, nah, it's not gonna fly. Because, you know, that's just how I am.
I talked to Dimitri Salida a couple days ago. And he took me back to 1996. And he said, I'm in a gym in New York, and Zab Judah brings in Floyd Mayweather. After the Olympics, you were hanging out with him, or he was hanging out with you because you were ready to start.
Yeah.
Tell me about the young Floyd. Did you know that he's going to become such a superstar, a legend, even back then?
We was brothers, man. We was brothers. We was coming up, you know. We knew that together we was going to be stars. I used to Floyd from young. He had work ethics that was different. You know what I'm saying? Like, even in the Olympics, you know, we would go do our workout, you know, with the coach, Al Mitchell, we would do our workouts and everybody go back. Floyd would do more shit. Floyd would keep going. Floyd would go back out to the, go out. I remember vaguely because me, him, it was like a little group. Me, him, and Zaire, That was like the group. Me, him, and Zaire Raheem and Terrence Crawford. We was the ones that hung out together. And he would go back and do more shit. Be like, yo, hold on, hold on. Like, he would do extra running. He would do extra weights. He would do extra shit. You know what I'm saying? Where you know what I'm saying? Me, I was, you know, I thought I had a dead arm. You know what I'm saying? I was young, but I said, well, I got this dead arm. I ain't training. I ain't do shit. Motherfucker, why do I catch you, motherfucker? It's lights out. Because, you know, in amateurs, I had a couple good knockouts. So, you know what I'm saying? I would always think that, I would always know that if I get close, anybody is in, get lined up with this left hand, it's night-night. You know what I'm saying? I proved it a lot of times. You know what I'm saying? So
Zap, one great southpaw is Manny Pacquiao. There was talk of him fighting Triple G. What do you think of that fight? Moving up to 160 to win a ninth world title, ninth division.
Nah, I don't like that fight for Pacquiao. But can he pull it off? Yes. I mean, I don't. There's so much power in any man's body. You can never tell a man what they can't do. There's no such thing. There's no such thing that I believe in. I done shocked the game so many different times. When they said he fight for a championship, oh, he can't do it no more. He did it again. You know what I'm saying? So, you know what I mean? So yeah, I don't like the fight, but yeah, he could possibly go up. You know, I'm gonna get it done. You know what I'm saying? So,
is that the only fighter you didn't fight in this era? Because you fought everybody.
Yeah, yeah. Pacquiao is probably one of the, besides the young guys, yeah.
How would it turn out, you and Pacquiao, if you guys did meet?
Huh?
How would it be a fight with you and Manny if you didn't mix it up?
All right, hold on. Let me go get Super Judah. Hold on. Super Judah! You know, you. I gotta go dig him up because I gotta, what's cracking, cuz?
It would be a big fight. Two southpaws going at it, Manny Pacquiao and yourself. He has the whole Philippines, you have the USA.
Nah. I like Manny Pacquiao. I have a lot of respect for Manny Pacquiao, but like he would say, he would beat me. I would beat Manny Pacquiao. You know what I'm saying? Personally, I think I would stop him. Yeah, but I think it'll be a great fight, though. He's a great individual, a great person.
Yeah, he is. He cares about people.
Guy, man. I ain't gonna lie. I met him a lot of times, and we kicked it. We got a good, you know, same friendship. Liking his brother, Bobby, my boy, you know what I'm saying? A couple of his teammates. But I would watch him, though. But definitely, you know what I'm saying? He's a good guy. But, yeah, I would watch him.
You mentioned Devin Haney. Out of the four big names, you have Lomachenko, Teofimo, Gervonta, and Ryan Garcia. Which fight do you want to see him fight first of those four?
Wait, say it again?
Devin Haney, if he could have a pick, who to fight first? Ryan Garcia, Gervonta Davis, Lomachenko, or Teofimo? What do you think out of those four?
This is a good lineup. I don't know. Lopez. I would say. Wait. Say one more time.
Vasily Lomachenko, Teofimo Lopez, Gervonta Davis, or Ryan Garcia.
Okay, Ryan Garcia first. I would say.
Why?
Ryan Garcia. Huh?
Why?
You know what? I like Ryan Garcia, but I don't like Ryan Garcia for the elite level that I know that Devin Haney is going to bring to him. I think that Ryan Garcia, you know, he's good, man. He's a good kid. He's fast. He's strong. You know, he's showing power in the game. But I just think that, you know, a lot of them shots that he gets off on certain guys that get caught with their hands down, he's not going to get that off on them. He's not going to be able to hit Devin with a lot of them, you know, they're a little fast. That, you know what I'm saying? And personally, I don't think that he got enough power to keep Devin off him. Devin gonna walk him down and you know, make him look bad. I believe so.
Out of all the fighters, young fighters today, besides Devin, who stands out to you? Like, who stands, is this?
Tank. Tevin Farmer. Gervonta Davis, who else? The Charlo brothers, both of them, both my brothers, Tony Harris, What else I like? I know it's a lot that I'm missing right now because I don't got like a list in front of me to be like, yeah, it's my boy. Like those are some of the main ones that come to my head right now that I'm like, oh, you know, plus Earl Spence, Terrence Crawford. Them is my, but both of them, everyone knows Earl Spence, Terrence Crawford is my two favorite. You know what I'm saying?
So those are my two. Happens, okay, when they fight, Zab, do you not watch the fight?
No, I don't even like that. You know what? I've been trying for a long time now to keep that thought out of my head and not think about them. Like I just, we was all together, maybe like, you know, before this thing happened, we was in Vegas together, or standing right together. I had Spence right here and I had Crawford right there. We all standing there kicking and talking, chilling. Like, you know what I'm saying? No, you know what I'm saying? Chilling, like, you know what I'm saying? Like when I come around my guys and we kick it, I like everybody, you know, like, let's keep the boxing shit. We don't talk about no boxing right now.